So in this chapter, chapter 6, cardiology, we'll be specifically focusing on our anticoagulants. The four different groups of anticoagulants that will be focused in this video are going to be our unfractionated heparin, commonly just referred to as heparin, our low molecular weight heparin, and an example of that is our enoxaparin. That's the generic, and the brand name is Lovenox. Then we have our vitamin K antagonist, commonly known as warfarin, and one of the brand names for that is Coumadin. And then last, we have our factor 10A inhibitor, and an example of that is going to be Rivaroxaban, the brand name for that, Xarelto. So for our first practice question, we have a blood thinning medication that does not require renal adjustments and has a rapid onset of action. Is that A, our unfractionated heparin, B, our low molecular weight heparin, enoxaparin, brand name Lovenox, C, our vitamin K antagonist, warfarin, brand name Coumadin, or D, our factor 10A inhibitor, Rivaroxaban, brand name Xarelto? That's going to be A, heparin. So no renal adjustments are necessary with heparin, and this does have a rapid onset of action. So our enoxaparin and our rivaroxaban are both going to need renal adjustments, and specifically our rivaroxaban, or our 10A inhibitor, is going to be contraindicated in patients that have severe renal dysfunction. Both warfarin and heparin do not require renal adjustments. However, warfarin has a delayed onset of action, and it can take several days until it can reach its maximum effects. So that is why A is correct in this question. The next question is focusing on our low molecular weight heparin, enoxaparin. So which of the following medications can be taken at home and is administered via injection? So again, that's going to be our enoxaparin, or our low molecular weight heparin. So heparin itself is not used outpatient. It's just used in the inpatient setting while it is still an injection. Then we have our enoxaparin, which is an injection that's administered subcutaneously, and it can be used outpatient. Warfarin and rivaroxaban, while they're both used outpatient, they are only oral formulations. Then we are talking about warfarin on this specific slide. So which medication interacts with green leafy vegetables and requires the most monitoring? So our green leafy vegetables are going to contain a lot of vitamin K. And vitamin K is going to help our blood clot. So specifically, warfarin works to decrease our vitamin K factors, specifically 2, 7, 9, and 10. So warfarin, in this case, is going to interact with a lot of our green leafy vegetables. And it's not that patients can't have these green leafy vegetables. It's just that we want to make sure that they're keeping the amounts that they have from week to week consistent. Also, warfarin, out of the list of medications here, does have the highest risk of bleeding. So therefore, it does require the most monitoring. Specifically with warfarin, we monitor something called an INR, or an international normalized ratio. And essentially, that measures to see if our blood is too thick or too thin. So it's going to depend on what we're treating for the patient. But typically, our range is going to be anywhere from 2 to 3, or 2.5 to 3.5. So anything that's going to be lower than 2.5 or lower than 2 is going to mean that our blood is going to be a little bit too thick, and anything higher than 3 or 3.5 is going to mean that our blood is a little bit too thin and increases our risk of bleeding. Our heparin does require some moderate monitoring when we use our APTT to monitor our heparin. And then our enoxaparin and our rivaroxaban are a little bit safer medications and don't require as much monitoring, as they possess the least risk of bleeding. And then our last question here, we have which medication requires monitoring of renal function and is preferred in patients who have an aversion to needles? So again, we have two different medications on this list that do require monitoring of renal function, and that's going to be our enoxaparin, or our low molecular weight heparin, and our factor 10A inhibitor, specifically our rivaroxaban. So we can cross out our heparin and our warfarin, as those can be used in patients that do have some renal dysfunction. But as we previously mentioned, our enoxaparin is going to be an injectable form, so that might be something that we would want to avoid in patients that might have an aversion to needles. So rivaroxaban, while it does require monitoring of renal function, it is an oral formulation medication, so that would be a good option for this patient.